Date with Candy. Date with Candy.
Bluster the Benevolent to the rescue!
So handsome, so brave. Why me? Why me? Why not somebody poor and unattractive?
I have so much to live for. My charm, my good looks, my mummy's money. What a sad, sad day for poor old me. Well, at the very least, I have my reputation. Oh no, my reputation. Unless I change it, turn over a new leaf. One whole week to make my mark in history. One whole week to become Luster the Benevolent.
Remembered as a straight-up honest guy who will gladly give his life to save the average passerby. They'll erect a statue in honor of me, a monument to symbolize my bravery. Bluster the Benevolent, hailed as a king, blessing one and all instead of cursing everything. I would hand out daisies and rescue kittens from a tree and pick up all the litter that falls in front of me. Maybe they will name a city after me, with plaques on every building, signs of my nobility.
Luster the Benevolent, hailed as a god,
spreading joy and love instead of bumbling like a clod.
Bluster the Benevolent wins the Nobel Prize for bringing world peace about in the blink of an eye.
I think they went this way.
What?
Gotcha, Cruel. Now we can... Oh, no.
I told you to wait till I gave the signal.
Sorry.
You were trying to trap King Karul?
You bet. I don't know how you monkeys brainwashed him, but...
We didn't do anything, except make him and Cranky friends again.
Friends? Well, that's even worse than brainwashing. We just want our old king back. Is that too much to ask?
We just want our old Cranky back.
Then, how about an alliance?
An alliance?
Oh, shit, we've actually already had too many Dark Gay songs, but at least this song didn't start, so I'm not interrupting the song. Cringey. Anyways, who's ready for some Lisa and Touhous? Because it's been a while since we got to Touhou. Also, Pet Shop Fucker sent me another fucking bullet hell game.
It's about actual spaceships. It's called, what's it called? Ikaruga. Alright, so the Ikaruga's gonna be lovely. I found a save. The only place I found last night after the internet cut out was the fucking cult of McDonald's. I found the fucking cult of McDonald's, so I'll backtrack to there. That's the fucking town. Hey, Dissons. Hey, everybody's fucking here. How's it going? Hey, Fuji, how's it going? Hey, Cringey, how's it going? Hey, Memers, how's it going? This is a workout zone. You missed a few Lisa sessions, except. Anyways, let's keep going. I want to check out the cult of McDonald's first, because I actually haven't checked out that area. I just briefly checked it out and accidentally triggered a cutscene. Give me one second. Okay, we should be back in a little bit more stable. You should quickly swap around servers, make everything move a bit smoother. Check out the McDonald's area. Suffering withdrawals? Nope. So I want to do, they knew what they were doing when they, with those fucking inputs. Tell me that. Yes! Oh shit. There we go. Yeah, the team that I put together is pretty good. I mean, Birdie and Harvey are already fairly decent support, so. Is that a deer? I'm just curious about this place. If it gets too hard, I guess I'll turn around and try the other place. Oh, fuck! DSA. Dropkick the fucking deer. You get for eating my McDonald's. Alright. I'm not sure how close I am to actually beating this game. How many areas are in the game?
give me 1 second. I'm gonna see if I can close some shit and try and make it all stream a little bit better. Here, maybe I gotta close my fucking Abyss page. I can't have DeviantArt open for streams because that sucks up all the bandwidth. I don't know. Three areas with a final area, so I'm already getting fairly close to the end, huh? Just keep mashing one button. Blow up all the fucking deer on the way up here. What was that? Ow. Okay, at least it wasn't a cliff. Is that Grimace? Little Nuggy. There we go. Yeah, we're ready. Life's good. How's it going, by the way, chat? Forgot to ask you that. Okay, now that's ass. There we go. Here we go. Ass, gasoline spit, shoot, and another card toss. Little Nuggy isn't doing very well, is he? Like, this combo is working way too well, to be honest. He didn't get up a single hit. Was he supposed to be like a mini-boss thing? Yeah, man, Sam. I understand, kind of. I've had constipation for a fucking while. Not lovely. Can you move? Oh Jesus, this deer's got bite. Lower your volume? Why? We're gonna get some McDonald's whether we want or not. No. The food is people, isn't it? Grant your request. Okay. Am I just getting really lucky? He's just taking no damage, is he? Oh boy! Mm. we could give you some, Okay, thank God. Oh no, he's no longer oiled up. Birdie and Harvey are some of the best characters. Okay, come on. Powers, let's wrongfully accuse you again, and, you, more card tricks. Okay, what's... Is he still blind? I think he's still blind. Yep, he's still blind, that's why. Uh-oh. He's cracking! Gasoline spit, like, he just keeps getting blinded. Like, we've set this guy on fire multiple times and he's just still kicking. Here, actually, let's give you some mystery jerky just in case he goes super buff again. Like, oil spit is what the fuck? Oh. I've got plenty of firebombs. Firebombs and some diesel firebombs. Okay, horse stance, thank you. Gasoline spit, he keeps shooting. Oh, so now he can't do anything, can he? Yes, Harvey is a fish man. Birdman. Oh, that's also an eagle. Oh. Oh. These guys aren't too bad, okay. Probably just... Well, we don't have to worry about Brad's TP because of horse stance. Jack's the only one we really need to worry about for TP. Not even really worth fighting. It's more irritating to fight than anything. And what is a lucky feather? Is that like an armor? Oh fuck. These guys don't heal any EXP, they're more of annoyances. I think that like meant that way. Oh, never mind, they poison, holy crap, maybe it was just Brad. Well, then again, Jack is rather fragile, isn't he? Here we go. Okay, can we use Harvey's, soak? Items, cigarette. And what is that? I forget what that status is. Fuck. You know, let's just fireball and just murder him. Well, where's the old sock? Fuck. Annoying spiders. Manuel, don't fucking spoil it. Like, really, man? Remember I told you about not spoiling shit? Just please, stop! If the game wants me to find it out and not somebody tell me to, let the game flip. What's up? Let the game tell me what to do, man. Well, let me find out the shit for myself, man. It's no fun when people tell you everything that's happening in a game. I guess sometimes it is, but. Spaghetti-o. Here's that buddy. Happy reunion indeed. I guess. Oh, and I removed the truck keys. Oh man. Hallucination. All right. Oh. Okay, then. Why did I climb up that? Well, the hallucinations go on, and I gotta go back. Yes, great. Like, that's where we started, like, before the McDonald's Mountain. That boulder. Oh, fuck. So I'm assuming if you took if Brad took joy at any part in the game, then he'd take the pill here, and that'd like, trigger a different ending, I'm assuming?
And then, I woke up, and there was hyper-realistic blood all over the screen.
I'm sorry. So joy makes you God. Oh, Jesus, joy. Seems fine on my side. I'm also assuming that the meat is people in that place, but... or whatever the heck that guy is, he's probably just a joy mutant and he feeds people parts of him. Hey, truckies. I just want to check out what happened to the town. Oh, everybody's gone. Hey, let me stop at the hotel. It was like here, I think? No, oh no, the banana gang was right there. Also, if you do a joy run, you get withdrawal every 20 seconds. I didn't get bow, I don't think so, I don't know. I got Geese Thompson! Okay, I've already seen this place. Only one place I haven't gone to yet. That's Muscle Gym. And one sandy place. I want to check that place out before I go anywhere else. It goes past here. This is a swamp. What does the geese guy do, by the way? Like, is he support, is he offensive, or whatever? No, shit. Yeah, I'm going in circles. Okay, I think it was up here. I don't think I've been here before. Or is that the bar? Yep, that's the bar. Hey Mega, how's it going? I think it was here? Oh no, that leads to the fucking Joy Town. Pretty Boys Cave is a small white spot. Hmm. Entrance. I'm really enjoying Lisa, it's fun. I think I've already gotten the item here. Oh, wait a second. Okay, that's kind of cheap. Hiding something in there, dude, that's like really fucking cheap. No, no, real talk though. Oh, that's the fucking Joy Mutant on the surface. Pranked. Oh shit, wrong button. Did I mean to use water gun, but... let's throw some firebombs. He's dead anyway, so I don't need to worry, except no substitutions. Yeah, actually, since I'm probably not gonna do it again, what exactly happens in the joy ending of the game, Manuel? If you take a joy at all, what happens? Like, what exactly is the difference? Pretty much just ending dialogue. I'm not sure if he's a con, but none but joyless is just more viable. I can understand that if you're right about the withdrawal effects. So the withdrawal effects is just like, ugh. Now we get the cowboy music. A duffel bag? Has Duffy etched on the side of it. Okay. I think we've done enough exploring and shit. The man in the beehive, yeah, I'm not gonna backtrack back there. It's a deer, dude, isn't it? Yep. What's up, dumb fuck? See ya, spaghetti? Cream first. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh well. We're still good. So we got, let's see, I think... Dad. Oh, Dad. that's not good. Jesus. Man, like, these are just really laying on down the beat down. Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, definitely that. I already got the DLC from the sale. And this volume's kind of loud. Give me 1 second. Ignore that. Ah, fuck. Whew. We have a water gun too. How good is that? It die. Easy. Restraining order? Oh. Stop running. Goo. Taste lead, butthead. Badass. Jesus Christ! Now I'll never finish my chores? Oh, he's a bab, isn't he? Little Diddy, what is Little Diddy here? Good, okay. In my bike. Let's be a crowd pleaser and splash with the nut kick. How about instead of DBSA? Cannonball! Oh fuck. Guard? Horse stance? I use fire, but I'm sure that's cheating. Hit me, brother! Oh, a rest point! That's actually really nice. A grinding station? Tag team is. Shock Lord. Oh God. Oh no. Lord. Fuck. Oh, why do I have to crave joy here? There we go. Nice. Now I'll just throw some fucking fire at him. I'll see you again, grind here, so this is how you grind up your characters. Oh, so you basically get infinite money grind. You can infinitely grind here, and yeah. That's actually really neat. So if you want any characters you want to grind up. By the way, aesthetics. The Devil's Machine. Oh, is that how the Burger Man got his flesh? Oh, it's mostly headcanon, huh. Oh, fancy perfume. Holy crap, this stuff is actually, like, really cheap. All Alright. Ugh. Whew. Let's try and actually, you know, maybe we could beat it tonight? Is that a possibility? Is there potential for game beating tonight? They're gonna save there because I just saved. Oh shit. Pranked?
I don't want to kill the fish, though! Dude, this is like the number one party. I mean, I'd kill him, but I heard something about how they're, Oh, Jesus Christ. Yeah, man. Oh. Oh, that was a fucking dick move game. Retarded? Why you do it? Well then, I love insanely fucking vague choices in my games. Hey, you can't call me an idiot, dude. That was a fucking bullshit choice in the first place. Like, no matter what, choices like that are just bullshit. I just redo this again. At least some of them are like, the choices are kind of clear, but seriously, like, that is like, oh, you're asking a legitimate question and then it just ends with that? That's just bull, man. I'll see you, Michael. Even then, there, like, that choice was utter fucking bullshit. Still, yeah, I got carp. I understand that choices are to change gameplay, but the choices like that are, even then, no matter how you put it, really fucking bull. Like what? It's like saying, what's it called? It's like you open a box, like, which has like the first aid symbol on it, and the box instantly fucking nukes you. That's kind of like what it's like, you know? I just want to see the Devil's Machine. Like, choices like this, where it's like, I'm not fucking around, this thing will instantly kill you. At least those choices are fine, because the game gives it like a really fair warning, but I mean, I just wanted to see the Devil's Machine. And then again, can I use the truck keys over there? Fuck it. I'm gonna go see it. This is it. I need keys. Oh, it's locked. Okay. How do I get the keys? Tell me, I want to go say hi to him from the bathhouse in Area 3, so I'm assuming I have to continue on normally. Might as well save here just because. Thank you.
Where exactly is the bathhouse? Isn't it further on? Further forward? Because I do want to go inside there. First door in Area 3, okay. Alright, so again, I'll lose a fucking arm because this guy's a cock and he's like, oh, if you ask a question, and you know. Slower climbing ropes. Oh, so we got a scavenger hunt now. Now he's a nobody. Is this like art sculptures? So he's making these things into sculptures, but then that thing, when he tried to make that a sculpture, he got killed. Alright. Mongolian chop. Boat guy in area 2. Not these things again. Two permakill attacks? What?
Am I supposed to be steamrolling through this? This is pain mode, right? Oh, so that's one of the hottest draw mutants in the game. Oh boy. Got some what? Devil's pads, was it? Swear to fucking god, these crab people are so fucking annoying. Spiders are just so annoying. Fuck. That's so goddamn irritating. Liking this part. What's Mystic Juggle? Oh, that's really damaging. Now we're in the glorious Nippon room. All right, Savio. Let's fight the beady dude and fucking just use all of our gasoline bombs on him. Fuck me.
Mm. Spit, you will try to levitate, scare him. Let's use our diesel firebombs on this guy since he's supposed to be the hardest. Holy shit, yeah, he is a tough son of a bitch. We have much to fear. There's a lot to explore here, huh? Okay, we've got plenty of diesel bombs left. We got plenty of explosives left. You know, let's try the bonus boss. Is it like fucking Atlas, where like it's an insanely hard an extra boss? Is that what it's gonna be like, Etrian Odyssey? The Abyssal God and such? The Yisgra del Kor? Scared, that's nice. Oh, that blinded. He's taking even more damage than the previous Joy Mutant. Minus 4,000 HP from burning?! Oh my!
80,000 HP. Oh, Jesus Christ. I'm at Mystic Juggle. Scare him, and you could use some more Coca-Cola, good sir. Oh, his name is literally Satan. Hit that while he's blind as well. I do have some explosives, don't I? Nope, now Birdie's dead. Ruh-roh! And he hit it while he was blind as well. Well, I lost Birdie, but who gives a fuck? We just kill the extra boss! He's still dead, and now we're stuck shimmying. Why am I stuck shimmying? Okay, yeah, that was supposed to be- was that really supposed to be the hardest boss in the game? If so- Holy crap. I don't care if gasoline spit is gone. Because holy shit. I just got... I mean, the 4,000 damage per burn was pretty useful. And that's right, my gang organization was right here. And who cares, Birdie, you will be missed. Okay, we have carp, we have geese, we have carp and geese for replacements. Actually, no, we need a support, actually.
fuck support, we're going all offense. Carp or geese? But Carp has joy withdrawals.
But Geese is buff, but also well oiled up.
I'll go with the Carp Geese. Alright, Fuji, see ya, and well. Let's go with Carp. Let's give him a spin in the arena. Crap, I did not mean to do the solo, it was button mashing. Oh, Jesus. Man's worst friend. And everyone's on fire now. Oh, and yeah, oh god, Carp is actually really good. This fat cowman die. Now everybody's stunned. These guys are all just such tanks. Oh shit. There we go. Armstrong, more like non-Armstrong, man. Let's do the dystopian, keep doing the dystopian rumble to get some, we're getting a lot of mags. Now, if only Birdie were still alive. Either way, Carp's damage output seems to kind of help him out, so let's find a save and call it a day for Lisa. Grandma's shawl and Grandpa's shirt? Oh shoot. I think we're kind of over-leveled right now. Now, holy shit, Carp's damage. I won't make the same mistake again. I will find a save after all that shit. Wait. We still haven't saved and we beat Satan.
Okay, wow, the fish laser. He birthed her. Oh. Oh no, he's stinky because he has a garbage shawl. Right? Just keep the same stuff going. Not to fall off the fucking cliffs. Oh, yes! That will seal Birdie's death, but hey. Birdie's death is sealed, but hey, we still fucking killed Satan. Oh, they're talking about the Blood Moon Tree. It's the bloodiest wolf. Hey Fuji, nothing much happened. We're about to finish off this boss battle. Oh shit, then I have to save. Oh jeez, these crits! Ooh! Go wolf in another life, wolfman. So he said wrist slash is when he starts to get broken, right? What does wrist slash do? Debuffs enemy strength, ooh. Oh, we need the wood.
Why are your people wasting fireworks, Cringey? Wait a second. We don't need to climb back up. I'm trying not to get distracted by the chat so I don't accidentally ram myself off of a fucking cliff. Hey, Non, how's it going? Okay, let's rest here. Warp back to Area 3. I think I've been in there. Where's the crow, man? Pair of glasses. Not buying anything because Gabe is trash and he's not giving us any good sales. Like, whatever happened to... Actually, okay, guys, real talk time. What the fuck ever happened to flash sales? You know, when it's like, oh, for 2 hours, you get like 90% off, and what are you? Herb? Oh, hey, Herb. Oh, he's a mutant shit. There we go. Oh, was that zero damage? Oh. and something's sending my frames to shit. Yes, insert generic terrorist joke here. Excuse me, I need some more beepus. Because, again, I will not pass out tonight. Don't worry, Fuji, I'll be able to meme all night. I don't know, Fuji, it's just a lot of fun to stay up with you guys late night at the Discord. I don't know, I always feel bad whenever I fall asleep. It's like, oh man. Like I said, I fucking love you guys. Oh yeah, even if you don't chill in the Discord. Yeah, always remember that. If I feel down, remember, the approval of some, random dude on the internet. And some good old Beavis. Oh, Jesus Christ! Whoa! Oh god, this snowman's packing some serious heat! Carp is still alive, don't worry. Next save, I think it'd be a good time to call it a day and move on to the Touhou. Beware of fucking snowman now. No! That critical hit. No, oh, man. Nice. Oh, carp. Sorry if you hear me slurping something. It's not. I fucking lied, guys. It's not Beepus. It's actually Coke, because I'm a lot of Beepus. You know, it would be a good time to call it a day. Well, we killed the extra. We literally killed Satan. Like, Jesus Christ. He only attacked four times, which is what absolutely fucking kills me about that battle. 4,000 damage per turn on burns. We were dealing, like, around, like, 10,000 damage per turn. Oh, man.
I'm not going tonight. I'm gonna move on to the bullet hell shit, because apparently Touhou 14 is supposed to be very piss-worthy. And Cringey's just been egging me to play it, and you know. You just can't let a friend down for shit, like, I don't know.
Touhou, I guess.
It's been a while since we last touched Touhou, so did I even beat 13? Oh no, I didn't even start 13, did I? Yeah, how bad does 14 get? Let's see, where is it? Oh yeah, I have it all organized into a folder. Touhou 14. Alright, it's weeb time. If two who's trigger you, feel free to leave. And maybe we'll do some fanfiction or shit, I don't know. I mean, I already really did not like fucking Touhou 15 at all. Way too much of it was like just, you got point device mode. I mean, Zun even said he wanted to make it like, I want to be the guy, so. Uh-oh. Alright, loading up the Touhou. I guess I'll do continues? I don't know. And that is fucking loud. Second. Alrighty. Let's get this trash on the road. Woohoo, yes. Aquamarine level. Hope Diamond level, yes. I don't know. Where are her knees? I don't know. Let's see. Oh, now she has a sword. Yay. I know, she had homing attacks, like, wait, unfocused. Like, I just remove the arm. Go Raymue, alrighty. Why? Oh shit, I need to rebind the controls. She has a rod homing attack. Alrighty, key config, let's get over here. Shot, special, oh that's slow, pause should be that. Thank you! I guess I'll just keep continuing to see how bad it fucking gets. Oh! This is totally fair. What kind of bullet is this? I'm sorry. No bonus. Oh, bonus. That's right. I think Cringey said something about how you need, like, you
Oh, bomb pieces, yay! How many bomb pieces do you need? Oh, you need 8, so... Oh fuck, did I really just ram into that? Ugh. Wow. Well, I don't really care too much, so... Hey Tetsuo, how's it going? I just noticed people said, hey, it's Tetsuo in chat. Yay! Oh, finally, a dolphin bono mermaid. This music is really subpar though, like, yeah. It's not just me, right, about the music? I don't know. The stage one music of all the other ones was pretty sweet. Like what, what was it? Stage one theme of, USD was good. Especially, what, 7's usual was my favorite. No, oh god, that was close. I remember you. You're the headless person. And what I find hilarious is that her unique ability is that she can just make her head float, apparently. That's what makes her really super fucking special. Wow. Congratulations, you can do something really fucking useless. Oh Jesus Christ, this is like a lot of fucking heart pieces you can get, huh? I just realized how small this was, here. Oopsie. Wow, Raymu, you're a fucking dick.
I'll make you have nightmares every time you see a head. Then again, to be honest, Raymond, you were kind of a cock-a-doodle. Sorry. Nope, I'm getting that, thank you. These the patterns aren't too, like, unfairly hard. Oh, five heads, yay. So good. You see my rod, yeah. And I don't know, maybe it's just me, but none of the soundtracks really stuck out to me. Like, yes, I really like this, kind of, like, great. And, oh, give me that. Okay, no thank you. Yeah, none of them have really been like, yeah, I really like this. You know, that kind of quality, like, oh, this is actually really fucking memorable despite it's the first time hearing it. I know, maybe it's just me. Oh, that was not a power-up. Holy crap. So, I'm guessing this is what you mean by abusable, Cringey, huh? Alright, need a swoop. Sorry, I need a swig of Beepus. Maybe I'm just a nostalgic fag for old mini instruments of Zun's older works or whatever. No, maybe that's just the issue. Oh, hey, look, it's another cat grill.
Or no, Lomp Garon.
Wait, actually, that's tight. Oh no, it's a wolf grill. Oh, that clutch. Ah, fuck. Did not bomb in time. Beat this, and I'm okay. No, thank you. No, thank you. I'm here to clean up trash, I guess. I don't know. Fuck, I did not see that coming. But she's dead, so I skipped that just because I don't know. And the music in this one, yeah, just like, yeah, I don't know. Okay, but yeah, it's like the music is the like a second part of it, you know? Oh fuck, Mr. Heartpiece. I don't know.
know, but I'm pretty sure those magical sigils. I know, hey, look, it's Ben Ben. Mmm. We now will decide who the strongest tool is. Just didn't give me the same, like, you know, the same oomph that I really usually enjoy from him, you know? I don't know, not as, like, upbeat to beat it as I am for our other ones. Ah. I don't think I want to deal with the inverted controls either, so... Oh crap, give me a sec.
I'm looking for Donkey Kong, the...
Hey, no, you're not.
I'm not
new. You're Donkey Rule.
Well, listen here, what I make it clear. I can't believe you can't see what we see here. A crocodile, a superior species. Your Donkey Kong initials DC. Looking at your claws, you could be one of my in-laws. Cause you're one of us, you're mean and green, scaly sheen. Can't you see you're one of us? You walk the walk, my brother Croc, arm in arm, together we rock!
Well, if what you say is true, then I guess we're brothers, same color with a similar hue. With these fangs and this scaly skin, there's no question that we're family next of kin. Cause I'm one of you, the same crew, nothing I can do. I can see I'm one of you, one of you, one of you, the same crew. I'm really one of you.
Okay, people are done yelling. You know, what should we do next, huh? We've done Lisa's, I'm not gonna do fucking Charlie's Angels.
Let's see, what do we have here in the meme folder? No, no, Cringey, no. We have, Left 4 Dead is still broken. Mince Wrap Story Strobe has been updated. Oh, God's Best Pilgrim. Crusader Kings, Jesus Christ, never a fucking again. Yeah, I get. Well, we could continue with Kerbal, I guess. Or how about we, I gotta eat fucking dinner. So I guess I'll eat dinner, I'll be back on the GameCube, I guess? Maybe, let's see, what do I have for GameCube? I know I have F-Zero for GameCube. I don't know, maybe Charlie's Angels? What else we have? Shrek 2. A lot of copies of Shrek 2. Shrek Zero, Tack and the Power of Shrek Jew. A lot of Shrek spin-off games. Or maybe we'll just chill here for some memes, I don't know. And Pikmin 2. So, I'm gonna be gone for about 15 minutes to get some dinner, then I'll be back. You know what? How about this? I'll just leave some Donkey Kong playing while I get dinner and come back. I won't hop onto the GameCube because I still gotta set it up and then I might have to reset it and shit like that, so...
Oh, cruel twist of fate! So young, so handsome, so brave! Why me? Why me? Why not somebody poor and unattractive? I have so much to live for! My charm, my good looks,
my mommy's money.
Sad, sad day for poor old me. Well, at the very least, I have my reputation. Oh no, my reputation. Unless I change it, turn over a new leaf, one whole week to make my mark in history, one whole week to become Luster the Benevolent.
Will be remembered as a straight-up honest guy who will gladly give his life to save the average passerby. They'll erect a statue in honor of me, a monument to symbolize my bravery.
Bluster the Benevolent, hailed as a king,
blessing one and all instead of cursing everything. I would hand out daisies and rescue kittens from a tree and pick up all the litter that falls in front of me.
Maybe they will name a city after me. With plaques on every building, signs of my nobility.
Luster the benevolent, hailed as a god.
Spreading joy and love instead of bumbling like a clod.
Luster the benevolent, wins the Nobel Prize for bringing world peace about in the blink of an eye.
Why are we going through the mountains? Cold-bloodedness? Those banana-brained baboons won't expect to see us advancing from the mountains. Now, quick!
My footsies are getting cold.
DK, slow down! There's no one chasing us!
And I want to keep it that way.
Get him! Looky here, looky here, look what I got! Don't think I won't let little Diddy drop!
Hold it now, hold it now, hold it right there! You wouldn't drop, couldn't drop, you wouldn't dare!
I'm a reasonable, raving, derangeable despot! I'll tell you what, we'll trade like a stock exchange! Wheel and deal, how's that deal? It's a steal! Diddy for the coconut for Diddy!
Don't do it, don't do it! He's bluffing, I hope!
I guarantee you to see, there's no pity for Diddy!
No blubbin', no blubbin', no blubbin', no blubbin'!
Wait a sec, what the heck? Let's make a trade. Give me my little buddy and we'll stop this escapade.
Diddy for the coconut for Diddy. I'm going to count to 10 and it's up to you then. One!
A one! A one!
This is fun.
DK, beware, take care, it's a snare. He's just scuffing, he be bluffing, it's Karoo, he's dropping nothing.
Two! You knew it's your cue, what you gonna do?
Gotta think what to do or my little buddy's through. Give up the coconut or else he's gonna drop you.
I'm touching, I may cry, don't you see? Do I hear three?
Three! Let him drop and then we'll see. Three, a three, make him Diddy fricassee.
Hey, big buddy, did you see? Did you see? You can save the coconut, save me.
Four.
When there's more, got a plan, got a trick. You can use your big foot, hit him with the big foot kick.
What?
Five.
That's no dive, take a dive.
Six and seven, time to learn a lesson.
Come on, big buddy, use your big foot kick.
I get it, I get it. Little buddy, that's slick. But I got two coconuts, so which one do I pick?
Eight.
Wait, I have to concentrate.
Nine.
I decide to or die running out of time.
Ten.
Nothing but Nana Slammer!
Ah! He broke my coconut! Ah!
Get me out of here!
Diddy!
Diddy, please be there! Please be there!
Nice kick, big buddy.
You sure I'm not some kind of monkey?
Oh, you be as croc as they come, Donkey Croc! Here! Seize! Here! Seize for yourself! Arr! Feast your eyes! Look into the mirror, or it never lies!
Square root of 25 equals 5. Square root of 4 equals 2. Square root of 9 equals... Javier, knock it off.
Silly when it's high. No makeup with some sweatpants on. Ain't no one can always be that guy. You can think about me all night long. But I think you need something to think of me. Something that will keep you warm and show you we can be more than just this. So baby, if you are not ready for my kiss, then you can wear my sweatshirt and you can tell your friends.
You know what we haven't done in a while? DeviantArt fanfiction night. Well, DeviantArt's trash its way to NSFW, if you know what I mean. Like, let's see what, like, warrior cats, or horses, or, oh, those are very... Those are very well-endowed horses, is all I'm gonna say. And, fetish fiction. Like, blueberry fetishes. Oh man. Looks like blueberry and fat fetish is the fetish of the day for DeviantArt. I swear to God, I think I told this to Fuji once. I think DeviantArt, like, trades whichever fetish, like, is gonna dominate the fucking front page nowadays. Because every time it's a different, it's like, first, oh, net, like, I think when I last talked with Fuji about it, it was all like, what? It was, it was BDSM fetish that day. Oh, if you do, Fuji, see you in the Discord, hopefully. Because again, it feels like, it just, I don't know, whenever there's people missing the Discord, it just feels bad, you know? Now, why not? You mean go for the day, Fuji, or what? You know, I wonder, what crossovers, what memes can we find? Like, what memes have we not plundered in DeviantArt? Touhou X Demon Souls. I wonder, does that exist? It does? Holy sh! It does! Oh my God! It's not like something vague.
I just want you guys to look at this shit. I want you to look at this shit. Oh wait, fuck. It actually...
Look!
I'm gonna go beat the shit out of my dog real quickly. But yeah, like I said, this shit exists.
Um,
Demon's Gen Souls. The fuck is this? Out of print? I'm sorry, I'm gonna look up this shit. What the fuck is Demon's Gen Souls? Oh my god. I'm still. I looked it up as a joke. All right, men. In 1 hour, we launch our final all-out prisoners attack. Excuse me. Once and for all, I shall be the supreme ruler of the island, formerly known as Congo Bongo.
Yo, your diddly squatness. What are we going to do? Go for snow cone?
Hello? Okay. Right. People won't stop screaming. Also, let's take the time to appreciate this golden skeleton. And the fact is he? What exactly are these previews? Oh God! You know, I'm not one to criticize. I'm not one to be a dick on art styles, but all these faces look like copy pasted, man.
Oh, in Demon's Souls reference in. Oh.
I don't understand any of this. Wait, well then again, it's understandable I don't understand any of this, but I never really expected someone to actually go there. To like, mate. All the faces look like, maybe just me, but all the faces look copy-pasted. Oh, it literally is copy-pasted here, or I'm not sure how this works. And now I get the FBI on my ass. my god, another one exists. Uh-oh. There's more of these than I expected. Oh. I'm sorry. I'm still confused. Ah, fuck.
Thanks, Eddie. So you see, Cranky, it's all set up. All you gotta do is push the rocket delivery button.
I'm just a hologram.
That makes two of us.
Using the pistol.
Diddy, push the big red button.
He can't. You can be here, you can be there, anywhere. You can go any place you wanna go, don't you know? You're just an image of yourself, floating in the air. Can't lift a thing, and you can't even comb your hair. A hologram is like a telegram. You can send it anywhere, but you're never gonna wear. You gotta realize your limitations when you're just thin air. Hold on a second there, I'm not finished now. Where was I? Oh yeah. You can't feel bananas that you wanna eat. You can't feel the ground with your own two feet.
You can't even eat bananas?
Oh, how many times do I gotta tell you?
You got
a hologram is like a telegram. You can send it anywhere, but you're not really there. You can't touch anything. How longer should I say? Don't you understand that holograms can't push red buttons? I'm gonna be a star. I'm gonna be admired by James Dean or Mr. Bean. See me on the town with big name stars, spending all of my do-re-mi gold cash.
I'm gonna be in the movies.
I'm gonna be a big star.
I can't wait till Kenny sees me up on the screen. He'll be driving around in a fancy car. I can see it now, the crowd begins to cheer. My name is lights at the movies premiere.
I'm gonna be a star, a matinee idol worshipped from afar. I'm gonna be a star. You're gonna notice who you are.
You see my face on every magazine. At all the biggest parties, I'll be making the scene.
I'm gonna be a star, a membership from afar. I'm gonna be a star.
Now just a minute! That's my job!
Get off the track!
Not a doing. You're gonna stop because that's what you do.
I think we're finally back. Good. There's actually quite a few Demon Souls X2 who things. Oh man. Who the motherfucking who, man? The funniest thing is that, even in Japan, like, even in Japan, apparently, Demon Souls didn't sell, like, a lot. Like, it sold like about 1.89 million copies worldwide, but like in Japan, that was about like what? I can't get the charts accurately, but it was like 134,000 copies. So even in Japan, it's still for hipsters. Boogie was deleted. Okay. Oh, he got hacked, or somebody broke into his account. I don't know. Why is there? There's actually quite a bit of Touhou X Demon Souls, and I'm not gonna look up Touhou X.
You, when you're faced with an irresistible.
Okay, fine. I'm gonna look up Touhou X Dark Souls. There's gonna be a lot more for this.
And irresistible is what I am. Hey, kids, the world
just isn't there. Well, surprisingly not as much. Huh. Yeah, let's do that. Touhou X Despicable Me? Minions? Okay. I have a bad feeling about it. I don't know. I can't really find anything. Actually wonder, why not go to fanfiction.net? You want, let's do this live.
Shit.
Oh. Guys, I found it.
Night of the animatronic. Greatest meaning there, oh. Hi, what night? I remember the horror of that one dark and mental-shattering experience that happened to me a year ago around October. The night at this restaurant I worked at that year before I was sent to the hospital and then quit after that disturbing place from that thing. The thing that sang off-key songs and made terrible noises after it left the stage during closing time, being shut down. It stared off stage with its eyes glowing till the curtains closed shut, concealing the beast behind. If I remember correctly, it had a name known as Beanie the Barehole. Oh God, what it has done to me. It did so many terrible things that not even bottles of alcoholic beverages could not save her away. It happened while I was doing my rounds down the halls in the Kitty's restaurant Beanie's Eatery. I searched around seeing if there was no one in there, and it was not being robbed like that one time when some poor foolish teen tried to take cash out of the register. Walked some more around doing some more laps and rotations inside of the building, checking it out till everything was clear. I began to walk back to the security room till my shift ends, until suddenly I heard a noise of something falling down. I turned around from the sound that came from the kitchen of this place and went to investigate. When I got there, all I seen were pots and pans on the ground with no one else around. I shined the flashlight around the room looking to see if there was someone around in there. I took off my hat and wiped my forehead as a sign of relief that it was just kitchenware falling to the ground. I then turned to walk out of the kitchen and noticed the curtains were open, and to my shock, Beanie Barehole was missing from his spot. My eyes widened up as I knew something was very wrong, making me think there are robbers inside the restaurant. I then started to hear a familiar song sang on the stage, which came from behind a wooden door near the stage. Shaking after I gulped, I slowly walked over towards the door where the song was being sang, and putting my right hand on the metal knob, turning it, slowly entering inside. I entered and seen Beanie sitting on the hard floor hearing the singing that song, only it was more distorted when I was looking at what he was doing. It looked like it was eating something, but there was no blood. All I heard was moaning sounds coming over there along with singing. Then it started to moving its hips forward on something which is kinda odd, till I approached and seen what Beanie was doing. My face turned grim as Beanie was jerking off into a large cotton sock, which is kinda strange that he has a metal shaft. He stopped and his head jerked to my direction with an evil, perverted smile my way, stepping back slowly as I knew what he was planning to do, which I didn't want at all, so I turned around and ran to the door as fast as I could, quickly shutting it, seeing a glimpse of the giant mechanical menace running at the door, slamming into his horns, going through it inches from my head. My eyes widened with fear as I took off and tripped over a chair and quickly got up from the slight delay. I looked back, seeing the door torn off its hinges, seeing the perverted hybrid grinning, looking to get a piece of my ass. I looked back, running more and more, running into a room and hopefully able to hide. I looked around, seeing I was in the costume room. I looked really fast and hide behind the nearest rack of costume, trying to blend into hiding. I heard Beanie
what is that?
Looking around the place with his glowing red eyes, with that disturbing smile he has, making me feel unease. He did eventually give up and turned around to the doorway, leaving the room. As he did, I slowly walked out from behind the rack of costumes, carefully not making a noise if possible. I went over to leave the door, then suddenly, without warning, his head popped out at a fast speed like a whack-a-mole from a hole. I stopped, stunned with fear, slowly walking backwards as Beanie's smile widens with perversion as the rest of his body emerged, entering the room, slowly approaching me. I tried to turn around and run, but I was soon tackled from behind my belly on the ground. Try as I might, I couldn't squirm or crawl away, being held by the animatronic's powerful steel hands on my hips. Beanie grabbed my pants and ripped them off my briefs, exposing my naked bare ass.
Oh God.
I was scared to death to what was about to happen, feeling a cold, hard, rounded object slowly being pushed into my rectum. but I don't want to continue to tell you what has happened to me because it is too traumatizing and made me never hear about animals the same way ever again. I lay in this hospital bed, my anus stretched out, nearly having my intestines pulled outward from the terrible ass pounding I received from beneath their hole. Note and advice to anyone working at food place with animatronics: there, never choose to work during the night, it never ends well. Well, I am now beneath little bitch and forever ashamed.
Oh. Oh. What is that? Where is that, Tetsuo? Oh, I think I'm gonna call it a night. Probably chill in Discord now because, there is a lot of I got teleported into Touhou World fanfic. I found two of them. This one has 200,000 words. And this one has I just want to say I got teleported into Touhou fanfic. Holy. So this is one of two that I found. This is one of two I found. Look at that fucking word count. Oh. It's worse. And this was the second one, which is, This here is based heavily on a on an Touhou roleplay a friend and I are doing together, and so far it's been nothing short of awesome.
Oh man. I mean, I know people can like, I don't know, play board games just for fun, just like, you know, a little escapism, but you guys did self-insert Touhou RP. I mean, 68 chapters. Look at how fucking long the first chapter is alone. This is like, it's shrunken down to fit into the page. But, I mean, look at this description. An otaku, okay, on break from college, finds his world turned upside down by the entry of a certain Boru Yokai. Reluctantly, he accepts a deal to do a trial run of the world he once considered fiction. Is this a Cerno shitpost, dude? Is this the guy who thought by killing himself he could enter the world of Touhou, man? Is this the same person? Maybe if I kill myself, I can fuck Cerno. Real talk, I want to write Touhou fanfiction. Jin Sokyo gets liberated about how the fucking American Air Force comes in and is like, you know what? These lollies are inappropriate. Let's take them all down. The newest version of James White's adventure. Who's James White? Is that you, Dragon Sephirim? Are you James White? Mr. White? Is James White the, like, long-lost cousin of Walter White? No entiendo, por favor. No entiendo. What is Jin Sokyo experience? I follow 16. I'm lost and tired, so I'm probably gonna call it a night now. So I'll see you fucks in the Discord, I guess. Cause I'm at a loss at how someone put this much effort into it, man. Like, old man's advice, really? Really, man? Really, Fonzie? Old man? Okay, let's just pick out a random chapter. Fine, one. We'll pick out one random chapter.
Well,
You know, wait, I've always wanted to write counter fetish fiction, but the only time I find the time to write is at night, and then I get fucking internet blocked. And I need the internet to research trash. Let's see, a tournament, oh. I think I saw, well, let's go shopping, is this what I think it is? Oh, hey. Boy, that's my line, you fuck. This is literally them going shopping, huh? Oh. It is literally him shopping. Oh yeah, no, well that's the thing. First time I want to prod at something, I want to prod at Vor, because really, that's the easiest to that's the easiest target actually, now that I think about it. And second of all, why does Marisa say oi? I thought she was supposed to talk like a cowboy, though. Like, she's supposed to be a cowboy, right? Right? Speak like she's from Texas. Not anymore. Okay, now I'm finally gonna fucking hit the Discord, so see you fucks later.